Happy Easter, boys and girls. I hope you guys are having a great day. Easter is one of my favorite holidays. It is so special and so wonderful. Boys and girls, we have a special little Easter lesson this week. But before we get into it, I want you guys to stand up and worship with us because He is risen, right? We learned about that last week. He rose from the grave, and today we're celebrating that. So we've got some special Easter songs. I want you guys to stand up for two songs, sing with me, and then I'll meet you right back here.
Faith is dead, I need a resurrection. turn it for good. You turn it for good. You take what the enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. You turn it for good. You take what the enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. You turn it for good.
Boys and girls, that was so good. Thank you for worshiping with me. Listen, I told you we have a special little service, a special lesson today. We're not doing our normal lesson. What I wanted to talk about today was just Easter. We've been talking for the past few weeks about how first he rode in on a donkey, and that's Palm Sunday, right? When they all praised him. And then we talked about the Last Supper when he was betrayed, and we've talked about how Peter denied him, right? And the rooster crowed, and then we talked about how he actually died. And then last week, boys and girls, we talked about how the tomb was empty, right? He had risen. What a miracle. What a wonderful thing. Jesus died for our sins and he rose again, proving to everybody that he was the Son of God. It's amazing. Well, boys and girls, I wanted to read you this really special book. This is one of my favorite books, and it's called The Garden, The Curtain, and The Cross. And when it's talking about the garden, it's talking about all the way back to Adam and Eve. You know, this was all part of God's plan. God knew he was gonna send Jesus, and it all started in the garden. So I'm gonna share this special book with you, and then we're gonna have a really special craft that you can do afterwards. So right now, let's listen to the book. This is called The Garden, The Curtain, and The Cross. And it's got really pretty pictures. Okay, a very long time ago, right here in this world, there was a garden. In this garden, everything was wonderful. The world was full of laughing and playing and smiling and fun. There was nothing bad, ever. There was no one sad, ever. And best of all, God was there. You remember that? God was in the garden with Adam and Eve. Hello, Adam. Hello, Eve. That's God talking. He had made it all. God was in charge of it all. He loved it all. People could see God and speak to God and just enjoy being with God. Eve, this is Adam talking. Eve, God's here. He wants to walk with us again. How cool is that? And Eve says, yay, I bet it's gonna be even more amazing than yesterday. It was wonderful to live with God. But then, one day, the people did a terrible thing. They decided they didn't want to do what God said. They decided they wanted a world without God. God calls this sin. Sin spoils things. So sin had no place in God's wonderful garden. God said to the people, "You can't live with me in my garden anymore." And he sent them outside. So Adam and Eve sinned, and so God sent them out of the garden. Look at how sad they are. To show the people that they had to stay outside, God put some warrior angels in front of the garden. The angels were like a big keep out sign. Now things were sometimes bad and people were sometimes sad. But people kept sinning because they didn't want God to be in charge. So no one could come into God's wonderful place. God said, because of your sin, you can't come in. God wanted people to remember it's wonderful to live with him. But because of your sin, you can't come in. So he told the people to build a special building called his temple, where he would live. In the middle of the temple was the most wonderful place in the world, the place where God was, with nothing bad and nothing sad. It was very exciting. But then God told the people to put a big curtain around this wonderful place. The curtain had pictures of the warrior angels on it. It was a big keep out sign. For hundreds of years, the temple curtain reminded people that God said, it's wonderful to live with him, but because of your sin, you can't come in. See the big warrior angels? Babies became grown up and had babies, and those babies became grown up and had babies, and those babies became grown ups and had babies. Hundreds of summers and winters passed by, and the keep out curtain stayed in the temple. It's a very important curtain. Then one day, God's son came to live in this world as a person. He was called Jesus. Jesus always did what God said. Jesus never sinned. And Jesus visited the temple where the keep out curtain hung. Jesus knew that things were sometimes bad and sometimes sad. Jesus said that God had sent him to open the way back to God's wonderful place where there would be nothing bad and no one sad. People still didn't want to let God be in charge. So they decided to put Jesus on a cross to die. It was the most bad thing that had ever happened. It was the saddest day of all time. But Jesus had a plan. He had always planned to die on the cross. What a strange plan. Why would God's Son plan to die? On the cross, Jesus took our sin. All the bad things we do and all the sad things they cause, Jesus took them all from us. And when he did, something amazing, astonishing, astounding happened. He took all of our sin, boys and girls. The curtain tore. God had ripped up the keep out sign. God's wonderful place is open again. Because Jesus died, we can go in. Boys and girls, Jesus died and took all of our sin for us. After Jesus died, his friends put him in a tomb. They were very sad. For 2 days, nothing happened. And then, the next morning, Jesus' friends went to see his body in the tomb. And it wasn't there. A little later on, Jesus' friends were all together. And suddenly, Jesus was there alive. Suddenly, his friends weren't sad. Now they were so, so happy. God had brought Jesus back to life so that he could live in God's wonderful place forever. And Jesus has sent everyone an invitation to come and live with him. He tells us, God says it's wonderful to live with him. Because of your sin, you can't come in. But I died on the cross to take your sin. We can live with God forever. There will be nothing bad and no one sad. We will see God and speak to God and just enjoy being with God just as he planned. It will be wonderful to live with him. And it's all because of Jesus. We will say every day, thank you, Jesus. You are amazing. And you can start saying that today. Boys and girls, wasn't that a great story? To think that what Jesus did, it was for us. It was because he loves us and he wants to live with us forever. He wants us to know him and to love him. And he loves you so much. He knows everything about you. He knows when you sin, when you mess up, and when you do really, really good things. And he's so pleased with you. He just wants you to love him. Boys and girls, we are so lucky that Jesus took our sin for us and died on the cross. And because he did that, we get to live with him forever. You can live with him today. He's with you right now. You can tell him when you're scared, or you can pray when you have a problem. And then when we die, we don't actually die. We go to heaven and we get to live with him for all of eternity in a place where nothing is bad and no one is sad. Boys and girls, I hope today on Easter, when you're doing your Easter egg hunts and maybe the Easter bunny came and visited and maybe you got a few gifts, I want you to remember the greatest gift, the greatest thing anyone ever did for you was what Jesus did when he took our sin and he died on the cross for you. Boys and girls, he loves you. I love you. I hope you guys have a wonderful Easter, and I will see you all very, very soon.